Hi, hello. This is a little bit late than usual, doing a live stream for me, but I was listening to my inner guidance, and so the message was the time is right now. And it's exactly what I'm going to talk about today, is about your intuition marketing versus following the blueprint. And this is going to be of interest if you run your own business. If you are my close friends who don't have a business, or you are my relatives and family, and probably apart from just saying hello, wouldn't be anything of interest to you. But everyone is welcome to stay. And by the way, even if you watch the replay, please do say hello in the comments. And if you are a business owner, please share the links to your Facebook page or what is it that you do so that I can connect with you and find more about your business. And also, everyone else who would leave the comment or watch the replay of this live stream can interact with you as well. So it's a mini networking opportunity during this live stream. So, what do I mean by intuition marketing? Intuition marketing is when you follow your inner guidance. So it doesn't need to be, you don't need to have a degree in marketing or a degree in business. Yes, you need to have a knowledge to understand where to look. Let's say if you don't have enough information about particular topic or how to run any side of your business, intuition marketing will guide you, or intuition approach will guide you where to find the information. You will come across, the live stream. You will come across an article that would allow you to move along and develop your business. And it's listening to your inner voice. Everyone has that inner guidance system, but not everyone has developed it. And your internal voice may be screaming at you and guiding what steps to take, but you're not trained to listen. So it's you need to train your listening skills. And then there is a blueprint model. Blueprint model usually is something that somebody creates a model in their business and it works. For instance, you probably know Jeff Walker, who has a book. It's called The Launch, and he explains the launch principle, and it's widely used by other businesses, and they use this approach, and all it worked for them. So they exactly took the same steps that are described in the books, or there is also a course around this topic, and they applied in their business and it worked. Somebody else has different approach, and they do step-by-step system, and when you follow that system, it may work for you. And it works for some people better than for others, but there are no situation when somebody has like 100% success rate in their programs. So even somebody looks at the same information and they don't apply. One of the cases is they don't apply because they don't use it. So they buy into programs, they buy into promise, but then something gets in the way and they get discouraged and they don't do anything to make those changes happen. Another one is that probably some of the steps were not suitable to your personality, or there are some internal blocks that stop you from being efficient applying the techniques. One of the examples I can give you is webinars. And webinars are extremely successful approach for your list building, for selling your programs, but not everyone are successful. Not everyone is successful at this approach, right? So you probably know it's either you don't have enough people on your webinar or nobody is buying your stuff. And then you don't understand. You seemingly followed all the steps. you put an invitation to join your webinar, you bought into webinar system, you created slides, you ran that webinar, but in the end, nothing happened. And one of the examples, I have worked with my clients and I supported them in being in the webinar environment, and some of them just picks up that so easily. I had cases when I sit through the webinar with my client, because when you have somebody who is on your side, so it's much easier, especially when you do for the first time. By the way, when you try doing webinar and it didn't work from the first time, do it again, and only after, you know, after you've done 10 times and it still, you know, doesn't excites you, then dismiss this as an approach. But webinars are the things that the more you do them, the better you become. But sometimes what happens is that when we do the webinar, we feel uncomfortable with the slides, or the slides, you take exactly the same, you know, like templates from ready-made experts who teach you how to do webinars, and you just put your content. But because you haven't lived through that webinar construction process, because it feels alien to you, what happens? People can feel the energy and it becomes very wooden, and you can feel the nerves, and you can feel, you know, the discomfort. And so people are get distracted from your message, no matter how good your services are or how good your, you know, offer is. People get distracted by your energy, by your, you know, nerves. And again, just a side note, nothing wrong if you feel nervous on your first webinar. It's not about that. But you need to understand what would be working best for you. Like, okay, take the template, but make it so it feels good. Here comes the intuition. So ask yourself what would make it more comfortable for me. And I know when, for example, when I suggested to some of my clients to forget about the slides, to forget about the, you know, teachings that people need to get the information through audio, through visuals, that webinar without visuals are impossible. The moment they took slides away, the personality shone through, right? And it will allow them to be free. It allows them to express themselves and share the message. What we did with another client, we removed the webinar model altogether, and we did just Facebook Lives. Yes, you may lose on the subscription level. People may choose, you know, I can tune into the live stream and they don't subscribe. However, I've seen that Jeff Walker also were using live stream as a delivery of the content. So you don't need to sign up for all the information. But it's not about that. You need, when you do webinars, you need to ask yourself, okay, first of all, what is the most preferred delivery method for me? If you are better on live stream, do live stream, make offer, give the link where people can look at your sales page and make the purchase. You will be better off rather than, you know, suffering through webinar and don't sell anything. So find your ways. Don't be afraid, only because somebody told you that webinar is the way forward, which I agree, it's perfect in approach. But if it doesn't work, don't try to remake yourself. Use the things that helps you. If, let's say, you're better with recorded videos and you can record several videos and you do the selling process through those videos, then choose this method. But tune into, you will see your intuition will help you to find that way. Don't be afraid. Very often we doubt ourselves, especially when we don't know. And if some of you are cooking, for instance, if you try a new recipe where you don't know how it's going to turn out, and you just follow the steps. And it can be a really nice meal, but it may not be, you know, the results that you expected. But the more confident you feel, or even if you are inventive, I usually, when I look at the recipes, yes, I follow the steps, but if I feel the urge to add something, to twist, then I will do it, and it may not work, but it may be even better than I expected, opposite to just following rigidly the recipe. So to sum up everything, is just use your intuition, even when you follow the blueprint, follow, tune in, and most importantly, okay, it's 21st of January today, right? So you may say to yourselves that you have a slow start to the new year. Again, nothing wrong with it if it's intentional. But let's say if you had like big dreams, if you wanted to start your new year with a bang and now it feels like it's fizzling out, so you may need to have a support system. You need to have a support environment that would encourage you to develop a very efficient habits that would propel you towards your success. And here comes the invitation. In 3 days, on Thursday, I have the first official business strategy call with members of the client attraction roadmap. And I would love you to join us. Of course, it's not free, but I will put the link in the description that tells you more about the program. But the principle, the main principle of that program is that you learn how to create systems in your business that work specifically for you, for your personality, for the level of your business where you are. And most importantly, it shows you how to enjoy your business. Because if you're suffering, if, you know, just thinking about where to get your next client is creating unpleasant emotions in you, it means that you are not aligned with your purpose in business. And you either need to stop doing it, or you need to explore opportunities, how you can be profitable in your business and how you can enjoy running your business. So Client Attraction Roadmap is a 12-week online program. Every week we will have business strategy calls where we look at the bigger picture, where we look at, okay, these approaches during a week didn't work, what you need to change, what you can do differently, how to build your email list in a way that, again, brings joy to you. However, I should say, right, so just all the nitty-gritty stuff you either can outsource or you need to learn to do it yourself. And doing yourself is less exciting than delivering your services and doing live streams, right? So in order to help you overcome, and sometimes it's not just because it's not, you know, exciting, sometimes you don't know how to do it. So I will be running an online Get It Done day where we come together, and working together, we will tackle all the tasks that are less exciting and that requires a little bit of effort. And I will help you so I can take over your screen. I will help you to either build your email systems or create Facebook ads, whatever steps are necessary during the day. So it will be like a very efficient day, and you don't need to leave your house. It will be online. So if you have any questions, please reach out to me in terms, send me a message, talk to me again, and tune into, if you were looking for the guidance, if you want to craft your business that helps you serve more people, that makes it profitable, that you can finance the lifestyle you want, that you can create conditions to your family. So if you want your business to support, allow me to create an environment for you that would support this idea. So thank you so much for joining. By the way, really appreciate those who were live. And please do share the links to your Facebook pages, what you do, introduce yourself, and so we can continue interaction after as this broadcast is finished. Thank you so much and have a lovely day.